begin, please help us welcome our headmaster, Dr. Fuhar, to the stage for the invocation.
Parents, grandparents, members of the family, special guests with us this morning, congratulations. Extended congratulations on behalf of our staff, our administration, for you as parents to get your children to this point. There's a sacrifice involved there, and I want to extend our congratulations. So to you, the eighth grade class, job well done. It's been a difficult challenge and a difficult year in education. And for you to get as far as you have already this journey, you deserve our congratulations. And so once again, job well done, and we can't wait to see you in our high school hallways again next year. Please, join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you this morning with heavy hearts. I pray this morning for the Uvalde, Texas community. Pray for Robb Elementary School, the students, the faculty members, the staff and families, the 19 children and multiple adults. Pray for the survivors and those that have lost their lives. May they hear and feel the prayers of a united nation and this, our Falcon community. Lord, we ask for protection over the BLS community as we finish on the last days of school, as well as the next few days of celebration and graduation. Lord, we thank you for the community of Ben Lippin School and for keeping our children, faculty, staff safe during this past year. We're grateful. We're grateful, Lord, that you have allowed us to see these young people learn and grow and lead within our middle school program. Lord, we ask for your continued protection and watch over our community as we transition this summer in different directions. But most of all, Lord, we pray that everyone has a summer full of memories with family members and friends. That they enjoy their time, and that you bring them back safely to join our community, or as they transition to their new communities, may they continue to extend the love of Jesus wherever they go. Lord, once again, thank you for another great year with great teachers, faculty members, coaches, and administrators who have loved and cared for our students. Be with us this morning as we promote these eighth graders forward in their journey. May this morning be honoring to you and the things that are said and done. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you. search for the light of day, the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run the things we know just ain't right. When there's a better life, there's a better life.
Down here, his favorite class he's ever had the joy of knowing. class, you know, exercise all the museums and monuments we got to see. And, yeah.
To end our time, I want to thank you, our parents. You sacrifice time and money for us to be here. You drive us to all of our events. You help us with our 7th grade book projects. And you deal with our weird music choices. And most importantly, you love us. Thank you, my fellow classmates, teachers, and parents, for making our middle school time so memorable. Go Falcons. We will now present the certificate. Rowan Allen. Mary Austin. Malin Bailey. Jonathan Berlin. Balatano. Savannah Bowman. Trent Boyer. Thomas Bozar. Mason Brown. Mason Clark. Silas Cohen. Ben Cole. Miles Coleridge. Sarah Gray Combs. Trey Creech. Georgia Chris. Ellie Portas. Ellie Davis. Junior De Los Santos. Emma Dickinson. Sarah Louise Dyson. Jonathan Edgren. Betsy Elkert. Quinn Evans. Ty Fajardo. Matt Simmons. Sadie Flanagan. Raymond Brazy. Joseph Gabriel. Caroline Goff. Abigail Greenwood. Eliza Helmadollar. Jules Hyman. Anna Hoover. Caitlin Kennedy. Annabelle Kipp. Ella Kirkland. Justin Polk. Caden Cramps. Landon Martin. Braden Marie. Tiku Babu. Zachary McCullough. Kate McElderry. Drew McGee. Daniel McMillan. Zachary McReed. Abby Moore. Ben Morris. Grayson Noreen. Coleman Parks. Nathan Pericelli. Olivia Pink. John Mark Putnam. Jonathan Rios. Yeah.
Cooper Trainum. Manning Turner. Dick Walk.
So, I thought about writing a speech about your class and many of the memories that you've made over the past 3 years while you were in middle school with Ben Lippin. I thought about how your class is the only class that had each year of their middle school experience significantly impacted by a global pandemic. But that seemed too depressing. I thought about writing a funny speech about your class's humorous side, and including things like how you guys invented an entirely new sport known as trash get ball, and how you've played it for 2 years now, and there still aren't any known written rules for this game. I thought about the great memories your class made while in D.C., the singing and dancing challenges for Fun Dip in the dining hall, and of course, the unforgettable memories of one not-so-fortunate Taco Tuesday. We'll move right along. That didn't seem to be the right answer either. So, I decided to look around and see if I could find someone else's words to help me write today's speech. Here's the thing, I have to be honest and tell you that half of this speech I didn't write, half of it isn't my words, it's not my fault. The first half of today's speech was written by some good representatives a real-life group of heroes. I'll be talking a little bit more about in just a few minutes. But before I do share their wisdom, I have to provide some context for how I reached this idea. It all started when this class was in fifth grade. Dr. Porter reached out to me one day and invited me to come to speak to your class in chapel, or the lower school chapel that day. And this would be my first opportunity ever to speak to you guys directly as a group. And naturally, just as any dignified principal would do, I showed up for chapel in a penguin suit. I think you guys remember well. But if you remember, it wasn't all silly. There was a point to the message that day, and I shared with you the importance of not needing a mask or a costume in order to be who God wanted us to be in life. We talked about being real. We talked about some of your favorite characters, some of your superheroes that you liked, and how they all wore costumes and had special powers. But then we talk about how God has made each and every one of us to be superheroes in His eyes, and how He has empowered us to go out and change the world for the better. That spring, after your fifth grade promotion, I remember talking with a group of you about what you were looking forward to most in middle school and what you were most thankful for. We had a great conversation, and that conversation planted an idea that leads me all the way up to today. The following year, you were here in middle school. You were sixth graders. And just prior to the COVID shutdown and virtual classes, we started a new activity and a reading break that every one of you loved, writing prompts. You guys remember those? In those prompts, you were challenged to write on topics such as the school spirit we have at Ben Lippin, thankfulness, and what it means to leave a legacy at your school. And so, as I mentioned a moment ago, the first part of today's speech was written by a few members of a group of heroes. Little did they know it then, but our up-and-coming sixth grade students were ready to make their mark on our school and on our world. There are dozens of these, but here's what a few of them had to say on the topics of thankfulness, leaving a legacy, and the spirit of Ben. And there are literally dozens of these, and I can only share a few today, but if you'll indulge me for just a few moments, I'd love to share their words of wisdom. In sixth grade, Drake Porter wrote, Ben Lippin is a special place because of the people that God has brought here. Sarah Sark wrote, the Lord has blessed me with an opportunity to come to this school and learn about Him. I think you can show you are thankful for others by helping being there for them when they need it most. You can also show gratitude to others by baking cookies for them. Sarah Lou wrote, I think what makes Ben Lippin special is the people here. I feel blessed because many kids can't come to Ben Lippin School and experience it like I can. Zach Swan wrote, I'm thankful for my family and friends and for all they do for me. I can use my voice to tell people about Jesus because I like to talk. Georgia Chris writes, Ben Lippin School has blessed me and I feel so blessed to be able to come here and worship the Lord. I love Ben Lippin. Ty Fajardo writes, I think that the school spirit at Ben Lippin is one of the best, if not the best, for a school. We celebrate the history of those who have graduated to remember their legacy. I feel blessed to be at Ben Lippin. Mason Brown wrote, I am blessed to attend Ben Lippin School. I would love to come back one day and see my friends that I will graduate with. Charlie wrote, you can use God's blessing in many different ways, but never put yourself ahead of others. If you show gratitude, you can shine a light in a lost person's world. Mary Wallace wrote, I think the spirit at Ben Lippin is one of a kind. It is different here. We celebrate our history because the students who were here before us have built a foundation and built up Ben Lippin in a godly way. Zach McCullough wrote, I will have a positive impact by being kind and polite to everyone I talk to. I can express my gratitude by reading my Bible each day and trying to apply the lessons of the stories to real life. Eve Smither wrote, I love Ben Lippin with all my heart. Ben Lippin is a special place because all we do here is unto the Lord. I am part of the class of 2026. It seems so far away, but it will all be gone in the blink of an eye. Even if you only knew. And as I worked through the stacks of these writing prompts and decided to pull your words for a part of today's speech, I got to the bottom and I happened to realize that, ironically enough, one teacher had actually written a response to the prompt on the spirit of Ben Lippin, which was a little uncommon. But the Lord works in mysterious ways, and I'm going to share this teacher's thoughts as well, because they tie in so perfectly. And Mrs. Cindy Crecker, whose last day at Ben Lippin School is today, who is retiring, if you'll give me just a moment to read her words on the spirit of Ben Lippin that she wrote 2 years ago, not knowing that it would be brought up today. For me, Ben Lippin is a special place for several reasons. First of all, it is a place that challenges me in my walk with the Lord. I'm challenged to grow in my faith by my fellow teachers, and I'm challenged by my students. I know that many giants of the faith have preceded me here, and I am challenged to be a part of their legacy. Yes, I am blessed to be a part of who have been and hopefully a part of what we are becoming. Hopefully the spirit of Ben Lippin is a challenge to grow in the Lord's likeness, as well as mature mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, and be shaped to be the best that we can be. Mrs. Cracker, we thank you for your years of service to Ben Lippin and to your students. superheroes. And yes, once upon a time, I thought I might get to play a small part in saving our world from evil one day. I dress up in a costume that my parents bought or made for me. I thought that by doing so, it would give me the superpowers to go out and change the world. But guess what? So did you. So we're going to watch a video here for just a moment. So sit back and enjoy. quite talented. So special thanks to the Ben Lippin STEM director for putting that video together. I appreciate your words, class of 2026, and your pictures to help me create the first part of today's speech. But this final part is the charge to your class as you prepare to embark upon your journey to high school. So what if I told you that the idea that you can be a superhero in this world isn't really all that far-fetched? Now, hopefully you won't walk around wearing a cape or a brightly colored costume. And unfortunately, you won't be able to fly or melt ice by shooting fire from your eyes or swing building to building from a web. No, you won't have supersonic speed, and you sure won't be able to lift a tank with your bare hands. Looking back, when you were little kids, that's what you wanted to be able to do. Looking to the future, as grown-ups, we're told that those types of superpowers are impossible to have. And while that part may actually be true, I'm here to tell you that you never have to give up on the idea that you could be a hero who could go out and change this world. You don't ever have to lose the dream of saving the planet from evil. In Romans chapter 8, the Bible tells us that God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. That's us as believers. He's calling us to serve a purpose in this world. Further in the chapter, it goes on to say, if God is for us, who can be against us? He's telling us that He's equipping us and empowering us to defeat evil. And in His Word, He tells us in verses 37 through 39, though in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Rising freshmen, listen to me. You're growing up in a world full of villains and bad guys. People who want to convert many other people, especially your age, to the dark side. And we need a generation of young superheroes who are willing to stand up for the cause of Christ and not fall victim to the kryptonite of the enemy. And everyone in this room today, and those watching from afar, believes that you have the superpowers to do just that, because you are a talented bunch. As modern-day superheroes, you've excelled in the classroom. You've won state championships in athletics. You've shined in performances and on the stage. You've mentored younger students. You've used the fun of our Spirit of Giving Week to raise coats and blankets for those less fortunate. You've raised toys for children with life-changing illnesses. You've led Bible studies. And as a class, you've read stories to lower school students who also see you as superheroes. And you've raised boxes of needed supplies for those suffering in the Ukraine. Those are just a few examples of your superpowers. Earlier this year, we all gathered together, we read scripture, pray for the healing of your classmate's sister. Ladies and gentlemen, we have seen those prayers answered. And Jess Cole, thank you for being here today and for being a superhero to all of us. We have an obligation to the Lord, to our kids, and to one another to not waste another moment of that which we can never get back. So, Let's pull up a chair together. We have a front row seat to a story being written by the Lord, and guess what? Our kids are the stars. Midlipin class of 2026, in closing, we, your parents, your grandparents, the extended family, the teachers and administrators who are here today, we leave you with this charge. As you step into high school, we challenge you to lead Midlipin into a future that best represents that school and spirit that you wrote about back in sixth grade, and that you still believe so strongly in today. We encourage you to be thankful for the gifts and the talents and the blessings that the Lord has placed in your lives. We call upon you to be a shining light in a dark world that is full of lost people that desperately need to hear about our Savior. And we want you to live a life worthy of being called a hero by someone who will look up to you in the days and years ahead, just like those lower school students and all of us here today do now. If this world is to be saved from the villains and the bad guys and turned back to the cause of Christ, it will take a team of superheroes to do just that. We believe that you. We believe that your generation may be one of our last hopes. Your generation may be the last of the superheroes. We all love you. We are proud of you. And the whole world is counting on you. We're going to change it for the better. Thank you.
Up all night, lying there in bed, listening to his newborn baby cry. He makes a pot of coffee and splashes water on his face. His wife gives him a kiss and says it's gonna be okay. It won't be like this for long. One day we'll look back laughing at the week we brought her home. This phase is gonna fly by, so baby just hold on. Won't be like this for long. Four years later, about 4:30, she's crawling in their bed. And when he drops her off at preschool, she's clinging to his leg. The teacher peels her off for him. He says, "What can I do?" She says, "Now don't you worry, this'll only last a week or two. It won't be like this for long. One day soon you'll drop her off and she won't even know you're gone. This phase is gonna fly by if you can just hold on. It won't be like beside her till her eyes are finally closed, and just watching her it breaks his heart, 'cause he already knows it won't be like this for long. One day soon that little girl is gonna be all grown up and gone, and his fate is gonna fly by. So he's trying to
coaches, Lord, how special the class this is, and Lord, over the last six, seven, eight, 9 years that you've had them here at Ben Lippin, Lord, that you've blessed them. And you've truly blessed Ben Lippin with their presence here, and I'm excited to have them walk the hallways of the high school. Lord, thank you for these parents that have dedicated their time, their energy, their money to put their students here at Ben Lippin, a place that seeks to honor and glorify you in everything that we do. Lord, without these parents, Lord, these students wouldn't be where they're at today. Lord, thank you for the teachers that these students have had, whether it's been in elementary or these last several years in middle school. Lord, I know personally these middle school teachers and the love that they have for these students, the time that they've put in, and Lord, the giftings that they've helped to polish with these students. Lord, I just pray for these students. Lord, I'm excited to have them. Lord, I've heard the stories. Lord, I'm just excited to see the story that's going to play out over these next 4 years. Lord, thank you for the giftings that you've given them, and Lord, the path that you've put them on. Lord, I just ask that you bless them as they take this next step, and as they spend these next 4 years in high school. Let these 4 years be a blessing to them, and help prepare them for that next step you have for their lives. Lord, I ultimately ask them, as they venture on, Lord, that they seek to bring honor and glory to your name. We pray all these things in your name. Amen.